فإن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Verily, the most truthful speech is in the book of Allah عز وجل, Al-Quran. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved and noble Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the most evil of affairs are the newly invented ones. فكل محدثة بدعة. Every single newly invented matter is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every single innovation is a going astray. وكل ضلالة في النار. And every single going astray has one place, is in the hellfire. I greet you with a greeting that which means سلامة من كل آفاق. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And this greeting has great in-depth meaning, which many of us don't really pay attention to. Because when I say Assalamu Alaikum, I am making a dua for you to be safe from every single form of destruction. From every single form of destruction. But today, inshallah ta'ala, as you know, the topic is why criticize us. And this topic actually came about while I was studying in Egypt, alhamdulillah. I look around, I look at many different things, and listen to many different things also, even from the kuffars, the non-Muslims. They are always on us. Sometimes you may hear it, sometimes you don't. And it's always some form of criticism. And then when we look towards the society and see the amount of evil is taking place, we have to ask ourselves, why do they criticize us? When most times, when we are living around them, like in Trinidad, the non-Muslims, you find that they are the ones who more or less are off the path in every single sense. So this is the reason why I decided to make this lecture on this topic today, why I criticize us. Firstly, what is criticism? As it mentioned in the dictionary, that criticism, it is disapproval expressed by pointing out faults or shortcomings. Now, not all the time that this is going to be a form of disapproval. It happens for different reasons also. Because sometimes some people, they may approve of something, but because of other reasons, they criticize you. And this is what led us to the second thing, which is al-asbab allati tuaddi ila naqd. The reasons that which lead towards criticism. One, insecurity. Sometimes some people feel insecurity about themselves. So with this, you find that in order to feel some sense of security, they criticize someone else. And next, jealousy. Some people also, when they have this great deal of jealousy in their hearts, this perversion in their hearts, they jealous someone for something which he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had blessed this person with. You find what happened, if someone speaks good about this person, then the first thing comes out of this person's mouth is to criticize that person that the good is speaking about. Also, wanting acceptance. That some people, they want to be accepted. Whether it be in the society, or in the homes, or in the masajid, or anywhere, they want to be accepted with something, so you find now that they criticize everyone else in order for they to be selected. Next, fear of the unknown or the unfamiliar. And because you do not know something now, and someone is bringing something to you that which you are not familiar with, the first thing you choose to do is to criticize it. And then you have the last, which is laziness. Which is laziness. Because it's very easy and very simple for someone just to criticize everything someone comes with. Rather than get up and work, rather than get up and help, rather than get up and support, rather than get up and give the aid, you find the easiest thing for them to do is to just criticize. And the hardest thing to do is to actually get up and give the aid and support. Now, in this lecture, many verses from the Bible are going to be quoted, inshallah ta'ala. So in this, I must mention موقفنا كأهل سنة والجماعة في كتب السابقة. I must mention our position as the people who are upon the Sunnah and who gather upon it. What is our position in dealing with the books that went before? عن أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال. أبو هريرة, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, he said, كان أهل الكتاب يقرؤون التوراة بالإبرانية ويفسرونها بالعربية لأهل الإسلام. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تصدقوا أهل الكتاب ولا تكذبوهم وقولوا آمنا بالله وما أنزل إلينا وما أنزل إليكم. From Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, he said, the people of the book, they used to read the Torah, Old Testament, bil Ibraniyah, with their language, and used to explain it in the Arabic language to the people of Islam. فَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. So the Prophet of Allah, صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ, he said, do not believe the people of the book and don't deny them. وَقُولُوا, and say, we believe in Allah and what has been sent down to us and what has been sent down to you. You see the circumstances here now, and this hadith is found in Sahih Bukhari. Because why? Remember, the Old Testament and New Testament and the Psalms and these books, they were truly revealed by He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were truly revealed, the Zabur, the Torah, the Injil, Suhuf al-Ibrahim, wa Musa. They were truly revealed by He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the existing book which the Christians, they use up to this day, it may still contain something of that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala truly revealed.
And if you deny this, then you can fall into some trouble. And also, they have some things in them that which for sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not reveal. And if you believe this is from Allah, then you're going to fall into some trouble also. So this is why you have to use the hikmah from He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when you hear these verses, what happened? You do not believe it, nor deny it. In a circumstance where the verses are clear kufr, where the verses are clear disbelief, which there are many. In this circumstance, we know for a fact, the moment it contradicts the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, contradicts the Quran, we know for a fact that this is not from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is only one and has no contradiction. So, we hope inshallah ta'ala that we understand this. So when we are given our da'wah also, we must have the proper aqidah, the proper belief in what we are saying and how we will accept that which is being said from the non-Muslims. The first criticism is in at-tawheed. Is in at-tawheed. The tawheed is to single He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out in every single form of His worship. Because the non-Muslims, they criticize us as saying that we believe, the Muslims, we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only one. We say He is not two, He is not three, He is not many, but He, Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, He is only one. So they criticize us for this, because why? They say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is three in one, or three of one. This is what?
لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٍ.
They have disbelieved. Those who say that Allah is three of the two. They have disbelieved. But these people, they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a three Godhead, and He is one also of this three. Then they say it's three in one and one in three. I don't know where this mathematics came from, but it's not from the mathematics that which we know that was, I think, was invented by the Arabs. Maybe this is a new mathematical system that which they had designed for their own selves, where it is three in one and one in three. So they said one plus one plus one is equal to one. When if you ask the smallest child in here, one plus one plus one, he's going to tell you it's three. But yet still, they brainwash us from small. Those of us who, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had taken us out from this bondage of this mental slavery of Christianity and the other religions which we were following beside al-Islam, that brainwashed us with all these different and worked up ideologies. But alhamdulillah for Islam. So we as Muslims believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is only one, and only one and one alone. So we said that we single out here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out with tawheed. The tawheed is to single He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out in every single form of His worship. Be it the three branches, which is tawheed rububiyyah, the tawheed that which deals with the lordship of He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone. We single He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone with this lordship for Him and Him alone. Alone, alone. Wa tawheed al-uluhiyyah, the tawheed which deals with singling out He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone in His ibadah, in His worship. Worship. And the third of them, which is the tawheed of asma'i wa sifat, the tawheed, it is singled out here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in His names and His attributes. So we the Muslims, we single out here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in alone, in a holistic way, in every single form of worship. And for all His actions, He need no help upon this. He need no support upon this. He need no one to guide Him upon this. Because why? He is Al-Qawi. He is the All-Strong. He Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who gives guidance, not the one that someone can guide. So He Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is perfect in all His names and all His attributes. So in this circumstance, if He is perfect in all His name and all His attributes, then He is the only one that has the right to be worshipped. Worship, worship, worship. And no one else.